Google has finally launched the Gemini 2.5 Flash Image Model, also called as Nano Banana AI. And as you can see, I'm having the ELO score comparing different image generation and editing models such as ChatGPT 4o, Flex Context Max, Qwen Gemini 2.0 Flash. But the new Nano Banana model literally beats everything in all the parameters except for stylization. And it has also been regarded as the best AI image editing model. So in this video, I am going to test it with 10 plus images as well as prompt to test its image editing capabilities. So to use it online, just Google AI Studio, click on the first link and make sure that you are signing in with your Google account. Here we are having Gemini native image. Click it. And as you can see, we are having Gemini 2.5 Flash image preview, which is the latest model launched by Google. And let's begin with our first image test. So this is going to be my first image, and this is a black and white image from the 1900s. And this image is not only decolorized, but the quality is also so bad. As you can see, we can literally see imperfections and blurriness. So this is quite interesting. I asked it to make the image colorful with improved quality, but I guess it has only improved the quality. So let me just download this image and open it. So this is the improved image that we are getting, and I really can see a improved quality because this is the old image. Just look how pathetic it looks, and this is the improved quality image. It has literally done a terrific job in improving the quality of the image. Of course, there are still some imperfections if we zoomed in too much, but overall it has done a terrific job when compared to this existing image. So yep, it's done a good job, but the only thing is it hasn't made that image colorful. So this is going to be my second image, and here I'm having a Japanese samurai, and my prompt is going to be just convert the face alone in 2D anime style and leaving the rest to be the same realism. This is going to be a really challenging prompt because it needs to convert a specific segment of the image into anime, retaining the remaining portions in that condition itself. Because it's easy for a model to convert directly the whole image into anime style, but if you want to convert to segment, it needs a lot of capability. And let's see if Nano Banana has these capabilities. And it has done an amazing job over here. Only the face has been converted in anime style and everything has been kept in realism. So if you want to open a new tab, yep, this is that image. So how good it is, like none of the background or the dress has been converted, only the face has been converted into an anime style. That's pretty good, to be honest. Next, I'm going to give this empty image of a living room and ask the model to add people to this room and keep it realistic. This may sound a simple prompt, but I wasn't able to get a good result last time when I was using the previous Google image editing model. I was able to get people, but the quality was so bad. Let's see if the quality has improved now. And of course, they have improved the model so much, and this is the output that I am getting. Yes, the image looks so good, the quality also has improved over here. Because last time when I ran the same prompt, I couldn't even see their faces perfectly, but now the faces are pretty clearly visible. And it has perfectly retained the background also. I don't see any mismatches in the background. So amazing work by Google on this. And now I'm going to input two celebrity images. We're having Altman and Musk. And I'm going to like ask it to create an image, both of them handshaking, and not even sure if it accepts celebrity images. I think because previously it's had some restrictions, like you can't upload celebrity images. Now let's see if they have removed it. And now they don't have any restrictions. I just gave the prompt, make them shake hands, and it has given the output pretty good. Yep, just look at it, how perfect it looks. Maybe you're seeing a bit of distortion because both the images are of different quality. I guess the Elon Musk image is of like different quality when compared to the Altman's image, but apart from that, it has done a pretty good job. Maybe you can like ask a reprompt saying like make the quality of the image unique, like both the sides. But to be honest, it looks so good. Here I'm having an image of a person, and here I'm having a toy. I'm just going to ask, can you make her hold the toy? Okay, so this is going to be a prompt. Okay, this is the output that I am getting. So it has done a good job in holding the toy, but it has just given me three hands. So maybe like I will just ask it to remove a hand, and now it has done perfectly. Yep, that looks so good. This is the image and how beautifully the person has been holding that toy, and this image is in perfect sync. That's why most people got astonished seeing this model, because of its capability to integrate multiple images into single image. That's especially comes handy in case if you're doing some fashion related ads and stuff. My next image is going to be this one, and what I'm going to ask is remove all the people in this image. The reason why this is quite challenging is because here I'm having people of different sizes and focus. Here you can see the camera is closer to this person over here, but here we are having people so far away and different focus and blurriness also, and the image is also not of that good quality. So let's see what this model gives for this, because the previous models that I tried struggled to remove all the people, and damn, it has done an amazing job. Just look at this image. Of course there are people in the pavement or the platform, but to be honest, this has done an exceptional job, because most of the image models that I used before literally will have people on the road, like standing. So this has done a tremendous job when compared to all the other models that I have seen generating this exact same prompt. So it has done an amazing job over here also. I'm having the image of a girl over here, and I'm going to ask, can you give me the side pose offer by giving the front view? Let's see what it gives for this. And it has given me the side view. That's literally perfect, to be honest. How beautifully it has kept the hairstyle same, and the side view is intact. Even the lips, the hair structure, the texture, and the even the dress side view is also so perfect. And even the background, like we are having this wooden background and this gray color thing, right? It has also kept that intact. That's how accurate this model is. That's what makes it so good in terms of editing. Not only it does the job, but it also keeps all the other things that we haven't mentioned in the prompt in focus. And next, here I'm having an image of a desk and image of a sofa and a chair, and I'm asking you to combine all these in a living room. So this will be super useful in case if you're doing some interior designing or home decor. You can like literally visualize and visionize how your home is going to look for different types of furnitures just by having an image of it. And it has done a terrific job. Just look at how perfectly it has blended everything, and just look at this lightning, how it matches on the sofa. And it has even kept some props on the desk. So I just gave these three, and that's 10 on 10. That's super good from it. So in case if you're having some design company or home decoration company, you can literally like use this API and make your customers visualize what they're gonna get or see in a particular room. That will be amazing. And next, here I'm having an image of a queen, super royal, and this is going to be my prompt exactly opposite to it. Show her in a poor outfit. Let's see what it does for this. It has literally kept the face. I would say the structure has been quite on and off, but overall it has literally changed the outfit perfectly. That's amazing. This one is so good, to be honest. Next, let's test with how it can integrate text onto an image. Here I'm having a image that shows blackboard and some random text on it. I'm going to give the prompt, add the text, subscribe to my channel on the board. Let's see how perfectly it can integrate it. And this is the output that it has given. It has retained the existing text. I thought it would completely replace, but that's fine because I didn't mention that in the prompt. All I mentioned was add the text. I didn't ask it to replace the text. But I've noticed an interesting thing over here. It has done everything perfectly. Like, this image is so perfect, to be honest. The only thing where it has missed a little bit is over here. It has perfectly matched the chalk, how it is going to get written on the board. But EL, that has literally come up a bit on the hand. So a minute detail. Apart from that, it has done a splendid job in blending the text on the board. This is going to be a interesting thing. I'm not sure if it can do it perfectly. Here I'm having a image of a shoe and the girl image that we used earlier. I'm going to ask the model to make her wear this. Of course, this shoe is not going to match the existing dress that she's having. Plus, this image is just like the top half of her. It's not even showing her legs and the hands. So the model has to like visualize how she's going to look in the overall view. Let's see what it's going to give for this. That's quite good, I would say, because the shoe, yes, it looks same. The shoe looks same because it's the light and it's glowing over here. This is like the dim effect. And I was wondering how it's going to replicate her legs and hand. So I can't see the hands. Maybe we can just assume that her hands are hidden behind the dress, but the pose totally makes sense. Like how the way her legs are there on the shoes, that makes total sense. It's normal and it has done an amazing job as usual, and also has completely retained her pose, like the same exact same pose, and it didn't mess it up badly. It's a quite a good job. Like in case if you're having some advertising companies, you don't have to hire people, just create a AI model and just throw your product to this and it can literally generate hundreds of images for your own brand. Similar prompt now, also the same girl with this jacket, and let's see how good it can integrate this time. Maybe I'm seeing like this is like so tightly fit, but apart from that, the matching and the sync has been absolutely good. Yep, it has even like made sure that even the small metals that we're having on the collar and stuff, that's really amazing. Like to be honest, this is the best model. In case if you are going to have like a fashion wear or a clothing brand, use this model. And next, I just gave Maker pose in a James Bond scene, and that looks so good. This is insane, to be honest. Just it has got the costume and it has recreated the hands and also the shoes and the background. It's on a rooftop and it literally looks like a poster. All you have to do is just put the title of the movie and it can also do that. And I just gave a prompt, can you make it as a James Bond poster, ad titles, text, all the stuff. You can put random names and just look at this, how good it has done it. Not 7, we are having the Shadow Protocol, her loyalty, his legacy, one final mission, and it has added some random names. That's stunning. I mean, seriously, this is like the best image editor model ever. So we have compared almost 10 or 12 plus things, and to be honest, it didn't give the exact or desired result in only one model, one prompt. I guess the first one where we asked it to give a colorful thing and could it give, and apart from that, it has done an amazing job. And this is, to be honest, Photoshop level editing. Just look at this. Imagine creating a James Bond poster just from a person's face. That's Photoshop level skill done by this within 5 minutes. That's insane. So do let me know in the comments what you think about it. Check the playlist of my channel. Done a lot of videos in programming and AI tools. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.